It is an energy of bliss, a deep, deep peace. And you will feel it. You will feel it wherever you are because it is within your consciousness as a soul. It is in the depth of your mind as an individualized form within the universe. And it fills your body and your emotions and your mind. It fills your body with a subtle vibration of ecstasy. You feel your cells singing out. You feel the tension of muscle melt. You feel weightless. And yet you can still move. You have not left your body, but your body has raised its vibration. You've realized that your body is energy, creative life force, and your body is singing out in bliss. Your emotions, they become free and open. The emotional tension, the feelings of restriction, feelings of being emotionally isolated or walled in, they dissolve. You feel your emotional body breathe again. You feel relaxed and at peace. You feel an energetic expansion, a deeper connection with everything around you. And you feel free. And everything is accepted. Everything is perfect and beautiful. Everything is loved by you. Your mind enters a deep state of stillness. The subconscious mind is at rest. Thoughts do not occur. You hear nothing inside your mind. Just silence. Deep, deep silence. You feel no restriction of energy around your skull. You feel expansion and peace. And you know who you are as the deeper awareness, as the greater intelligence. Now that your body, emotions, and mind are open and settled, your consciousness is able to expand its depth and reach into the non-physical, non-human realities. And here you experience higher vibrations, higher understanding, greater feeling. And there is a bliss that arises from the center of your consciousness. A bliss so great. A bliss so pure. A bliss not of this world, but yet experienced by you while you are in it. And this bliss is divine love. It celebrates everything. It embraces everything. It holds on to nothing. Let's life flow. And the more you surrender into this love, the more you give yourself to God, the greater the love becomes. The more beautiful reality becomes. The more you know what the universe is. There are remarkable states of bliss. You, dear ones, are consciousness. You are pure and total consciousness. To reach these higher states of non-physical reality, to reach these greater states of peace and bliss, you must free yourself from your mind. You must free yourself from identifying with your thoughts. You must stop your emotional patterns of restriction. You must realize the body is just a tool, like the hammer within your hand. What do you want, dear ones? What does your heart sing for? There are so many ideas within this world. There are so many ideas within the universe. And you are free to choose any. There are so many vibrations of feeling, and you are free to choose any. There are so many actions your body can take, places where your body can inhabit. And you are free to choose any. The choices you make as a human being determine what your life will be. Try to see your freedom. You need not be a certain way. You need not think, feel, or act a certain way. You are free. Break down this system of identification with limitation, and you will know your freedom. You yearn for greater things, you want greater things, and we are telling you how. Stop, dear ones. Stop telling yourself you are a certain type of person, and be truly courageous and surrender to God as the nothingness. Transcend your fear. Transcend your fear by surrendering into silence. You cannot control this. You must give it up. When you surrender into silence, dear ones, your awareness will go deeper and deeper, beyond identification with the body, beyond identification with the mind and with the emotional energies. You must be willing to be nothing, because everything you believe is about being a human. You must be willing to be nothing. So you can think nothing and feel nothing and move nothing in your physical human form. And then your spirit can be free. Your awareness can go deeper. Your consciousness can expand, and you can realize what you are for eternity. And when you come back to the human experience, that freedom will remain. And you will live from a new place, not like other human beings, but like yourself. You can walk in this world as an enlightened man or woman at any age, in any country. Your body can take any appearance. These things do not matter. What matters is your depth of freedom, your ability to transcend your fear and your attachment to being human. The mind, emotions, and body are tools of expression and experience that allow you to interact with the world, just as a hammer is held by the hand to allow you to construct a home. Your mind has beliefs, and you tell the world who you are. You argue with the world when it does not appear the way your mind wants it to. You argue with people when they see you in a different way than you want to be seen. And you feel sadness and anger towards them or towards yourself. And like a rat in a maze, you circle again and again and again, not understanding why you feel this way, not understanding why the world acts this way, not understanding why you are trapped. You are trapped because you're still trying to move the world with your mind. You are trapped because you're still trying to be a limited type of person in an unlimited universe. You are still trapped because you've not surrendered yourself to God fully enough yet. You may have surrendered yourself to a God of happiness, to a God that possesses only the ideas that you prefer, but have you surrendered yourself to the God of everything? And does this surrender go deep into the cells of your body, the fibers of your energy system, and the vibrations of your mind? How deep have you surrendered? How deep have you let go? How far is your fear removed? Your minds identify with being a form because it is safe to you. It is safe if you are experiencing life the way your mind prefers. And when your mind is seeing conflict within your own thoughts, your emotions, or the world around you, then your feeling of safety also is reduced. And this creates fear. And you must act to push the world back to how it should be. You must act to hold the world in its proper place. And you resist, and you struggle, and you fight, and you feel weak and helpless. You feel afraid or enraged. Your mind is projecting onto the world, saying you cannot be this way. You must be happy. You must see me as happiness. I can only be happy. Look at this. Look at this. You will only find peace when you let the world be what it is. You will only be able to control your own mind, emotions, and body when you first let yourself be who you are.